You might think it's a bad thing, but I have no problem with it whatsoever. So put your fupa on me. That probably caused you to chuckle, giggle, laugh a bit, and that's okay. I've seen it. I've seen it tucked into your leggings, tucked into your undergarments, underneath your blouse, underneath your t-shirt, but when it comes down to the come down, and those jeans, those leggings come off, those panties come off, that blouse comes off, and you might feel self-conscious about it, but there's no need for that. Put your fupa on me. As I lean forward to taste the juices and the delicacy that is your chasm, that is the undercarriage of your body, I simply want you to put your fupa, rest it on the top of my bald head, rest it on my forehead, and let me do what I came here to do. Let me satiate my hunger. Let me quench my thirst. Let me find myself in the covenant of your warmth that is. Put your fupa on me. And you don't even have to hold it. I know how to work without hands. As your shoulders, I lean back and relax. As your legs come across my shoulders. As my hands normally grip your ass. I can look upward and hold on to the fupa of your life to make sure I don't drown. So, by all means, rest your fupa on me. Put it wherever you need to put it. Heck, to be quite honest with you, I might bring some peanut butter or some mild sauce and smother it on your fupa. Have that as an appetizer before the actual meal, or dessert after the actual meal. But just let your subconsciousness go. I don't care what society may have to say. When it comes down to the come down, put your fupa on me so I can begin my meal and my drink. This has been my poem. My name is Jim. I'm in my backpack. And I'm out.